understand? Jesus. Good evening, everybody. I greet you in the wonderful name of Jesus. We want to welcome you to Bible Truth Ministries. Hallelujah. Stephen, I just want to read a scripture before we start. It's taken from Revelation chapter 21, reading verse 3 and verse 4. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, "Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be in his people. And the God himself shall be with them and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from your eyes. And there shall no more death, neither sorrow nor crying. Neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away." Hallelujah, Jesus. Let's all stand in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I want to invite Mr. Tony Ballard to come and open us in a word of prayer. Hallelujah, Jesus.
You all join me in prayer at this present time. Heavenly Father, once again, merciful God, I've been granted this opportunity, dear merciful God, to come before your throne of grace, Lord. And Father God, we are asking you at this present time, O merciful God, to open the eyes of the heaven unto each and every one of us today. Father God, we humble ourselves before your throne, Lord. And as we seek thee, O merciful God, we are asking you, dear merciful God, to open your eyes upon my brother today, Lord. Father, you know him. You know his every effort that he have made unto life, dear Lord. And now he is passed on to you, Lord, thy God. Father God, a son of the soil, a son that you have given unto us, Lord God. And now you have taken him, Lord. Lord, thy God, we are asking you once again, dear merciful God, to watch over him, O Lord God, because we are handing him over unto thee, O Most High God. And at this present time, we are asking you, dear Lord, for peace, dear Lord God. Even though for those who have laid whatever it is that they have done to him, Lord, we ask for forgiveness unto them, Lord. Father, let your mercy be upon each and everyone. Even though as we cry, dear merciful God, for you know the sorrows at this present time that we are going through. But Lord, thy God, we are asking you once again, merciful God, let mercy prevail unto each and everyone. And we are still asking forgiveness on those that may have done this deed unto our brother today, Lord. Father God, your child today is laid to rest, dear merciful God. And he is before you, O Lord, thy God. So I'm asking you today, dear Lord, I beseech you to watch over him, dear Lord, and let your judgment be unto him, dear Lord God. Thy true judgment, which we know that you are the judge today. You are the judge in everything, dear merciful God. So as we seek thee, O Lord, thy God, we ask thee in no other name but in Jesus' almighty name. Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Tony. Hallelujah. As we remain standing, we want to invite the Bala family, and they are going to be doing the worship. You all can clap, you can dance in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. We're going to invite you all to come up. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Scripture reading is done by Belinda Bala Walker. Let's welcome as she comes. Straker.
Good evening, everyone. Before I read the scripture, I was just reading a part of it, not the whole thing, but I just really want to say thank you to everybody for their wonderful support, you know. At this time, as a family, we're really going through a difficult time, and especially my mom. So I really want to say from the bottom of my heart, thank you all so much. Today I'm reading from Ecclesiastes 3. As I said, I'll read a part of it, and then I want to read from Proverbs chapter 3. There's two verses. So, to everything, there is a season, and a time to every purpose under heaven, a time to be born, and a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to pluck up that which is planted, a time to kill, and a time to heal, a time to break down, and a time to build up, a time to weep, and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones, and a time to gather stones together, A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to get and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to cast away. A time to render and a time to sow. A time to keep silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time of war and a time of peace. What profit had he that worketh in that wherein he labored? I have seen the travail which God had given to the Son of Man to exercise it in. He had made everything beautiful in his time. Also, he had set the world in their hearts so that no man can find out the work that God maketh from the beginning to the end. And I end there. One minute, huh? Robert, say a joke. One of the reasons why I just want to read it, I wanted to say it to myself, just remembering the scripture. Today I went to see my brother before he came here to view in first. And when I went to see him, this was what the word was to me. And I hope that this could be the word to everybody else here too. Let me just say, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, thy soul, with all thy mind. And lean not unto your own understanding, and all thy ways acknowledge thy part. And he will acknowledge thy part. I don't want to say I think I'm mixing up everything. Right? So that I wanted to read it from the Bible right here, man. The reason why, when I went to see my brother today, this is what God said to me, and it's one of the scripture verses I actually always use. Like when things happen, it makes you feel sad, but what did God say? Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thy own understanding. And in all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your paths. That's the word I got today when I went and saw my brother. And that is the peace that God has given me today to stand and to do this. I've asked him for peace, and he has blessed me with peace. I thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. At this time, we're going to have a eulogy, and it's done by Cleo Walker. Let's welcome her as she comes this evening. Hallelujah.
Good afternoon to all. I would like to say by saying thank you for gathering here today to pay tribute to the life of Allison Balla, better known as McLean or Bling Bling in Tobago, which has been his home for the past 17 years and so. Tobago embraced him as their own. Allison was born to Reginald and Agatha Balla on the 6th of December 1966 at San Fernando General Hospital. He was the second son and the fifth born of 11 children. He attended Reform Presbyterian Primary School and began his career as an entrepreneur selling nuts in the village and other surrounding areas. First on foot, then on bicycle. Sales was in his nature from an early age. He could sell anything, given the opportunity, from nuts to clothing, household items, fruits and vegetables, and also used vehicles. Allison was a free-spirited, funny, energetic, easygoing, loving, giving, and generous person. He never hesitated to do anything for anyone. A true family man he was. always there when you needed him. He was the life of the party, function and gathering. He was always building and for fixing something. A jack of all trades and a master of many. He loved and cherished his children, the six he had, biologically, and every one of his stepchildren. He endeavored to be the best dad he could be and they could ever need. He welcomed everyone and was never judgmental. His motto or slogan as a businessman was, "It's a bargain, not a begging." He peddled his merchandise with dignity, even if described as a true hustler. He did so with pride to provide. Sunday to Sunday, he was always on the grind. Some called him a real ladies' man, but a man of God he was. Loved to convince you to give your life to Christ and remind you to pray always. Loved his gospel whenever things happen in his life. Whether good or bad, he would always say, "That's God's work." His favorite saying was, "God is sailing my ship." His favorite song was, "Jesus is love," and Allison was love. There's so much more that I can say or could be said, but if I were to continue, we would be here for a long time. In a nutshell, Allison was not a perfect man, but he was a great man to us all. Words can never explain the person he was. He will surely be missed. He will surely be missed and loved by all. I know for all those who had the opportunity to be a part of his life, his memory will live on in their hearts forever. I thank you for letting me get to know you. We love you, our friend, our uncle, cousin, and brother. Fly high with the angels. Thank you.
Thank you, Cleo. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. This time we're going to hear from the Word of God. Let's welcome my mom, Pastor Rosa Paul, as she comes to minister the Word of God. Let's welcome her this evening.
Sad day today for us to meet on this occasion, and it is always sad when you have to do what I'm doing here, doing a final service for the one that you love. Agatha, my heart goes out to you and to your children and grandchildren, and I understand great grandchildren. I thank God that he will see you through this, because as we say, this too shall pass. And all to all the relatives and friends that are here, we are thankful that you are here to hold up the hands of the family, because it's never an easy thing losing a loved one. For those of you who have been there, you know what I'm speaking about. I've been there, done that. But the person you never forget, and when it's your son, as a mother myself, it's even more painful. I pray that I wouldn't have to stand in your shoe, because it's not a nice place to be. It's a heartache that never ends. The ache is always there when it's someone who has come from you, you know. But what do? We know, but we don't know about tomorrow, but we know who holds tomorrow. And we thank God that He has us in His hands. And at one time I thought that his sister was doing my message. So I would all, only thing I would have to do is come and say amen. But this is how the Holy Spirit works. Ecclesiastes 3 and verse 1. To everything there is a season, and there's a time to every purpose under the heavens. There is a time to plant and a time to reap what is planted. A time to tear down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to embrace and a time to shun embracing. A time to search and a time to give up as lost. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear apart and a time to sew together. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to born or be born. And certainly there is a time to die. One that we are never prepared to do. No one here is prepared to want to die. But it is interesting that several thousand years ago, Solomon penned these words that seem so appropriate today. For everything, there is a time and a season. A time to be born and a time to die. In an instant, as what happened here to Anderson. As you all know him by Allison. I know he was supposed to be Anderson. And I knew him as Anderson. This is a time to be born and a time to die. It may be the most important question we can answer is what time is it? And what time is it? Those that are alive, we who are here today, has to ask ourselves that question. What time is it for you? And only you can answer that. Because nobody knew that we would be coming here today to something like this. And someone will say, well, heaven rejoices when an angel goes back to his home. But the question lies with us here today. Are we ever ready for this time? I can leave here or be standing here right now and I fall down. I just pass away. Nobody knows. And this is a secret that God has kept from each and every one of us so that we be ready at all times. We know that we are creatures of time by the way we set our clocks and watches so that we will know what hour it is in the 24 hours that we know. We have schedules, we have appointments set by dates on a calendar. We know large amounts of time by measuring the months of the year. We also know the seasons. Well, that is in Trinidad and Tobago, of dry and rainy seasons. But together and today, I want to challenge your thoughts to tell you perhaps time should be measured in more than hours and days or years or even seasons. We have already mentioned some dates here. The date that Anderson was born, as you would see in your program, and the day he died. So we know that he lived. And if you were to ask me, from a young man, seeing him riding his bicycle, plying his job, plying his work, that would be 46 years. I am living here, and it's 46 years I know him. And I would say it was too short. Gone too soon. Because he was always respectable to me. I can't speak for nobody else, but he was always respectable to me. And he would come to church here, and I remember his brother, his big brother, Tony. Those memories will never fail Tony, of Tony coming and teaching us here in church with the youth groups to march. And there wasn't a competition that we went to that we didn't win. Tony did a fine job. And I'm proud of you, son. And I thank you for being there for your mom, you know, as the big brother. And for Val. You know, Val, I know it's hard for you. I know it's hard for you. And I know it's hard for the rest of the family, the in-laws, and the friends, and the neighbors that grew to know Anderson. So we would say the measurement of his time, it was too short. And some of us are sitting here thinking, he lived a full, long life, while others are thinking that it was cut short, and I'm one of them. But life is much more than a measurement of years or accomplishments. Perhaps our lives should be measured by the relationships that we have with others. That is who you are here today, isn't it? Because all of you who are here today knew him in some form or fashion. And this is the reason why you are here. Because you knew him. You are family. You are friends. And you have come to say goodbye. Very hard word. Even in the physical, if one is leaving to go abroad, it's a difficult thing to say goodbye. I would think it's not a nice word. And even if you say it in French, au revoir, it's still goodbye. But we will say today, who have a hope until we meet again? Because we live with a hope. That is important. And I commend you for being here today, those of you that are here and probably viewing online, I don't know. Perhaps our lives should be measured by relationships. But let me ask, what time is it for you today? Because Anderson have done his part. He have lived his life. For those who are left behind, what time of day is it for you? And only you can answer that. The writer of Ecclesiastes has said there is a time and a season for every event under heaven. There is a time to weep and a time to mourn. And this here is something that we don't like to do. Nobody likes to mourn. Nobody likes to be put into this position that we are in here today. Because it's sad. It's sorrowful. There's nothing to be happy about. As I look to your faces, I see no expression. And to some, expression of sadness. It tells of who we are inside of us. Because inside of us, we are emotional beings. And regardless of what you might be saying, we are all full of emotions. Happiness is one of the emotions, and so too sadness is one of emotions. But we would not like to be sad, but you know what? It happens. I've been to many a funeral, married a lot of people too. And you have different spheres of life and living. So I would like to say for you who are family and friends and neighbors that today is a day of mourning. Today is a day of not mourning, but mourning. A day of sadness. A day when you would like to know that you didn't have to be here today. The sacrifices you would have made to be here, you would have chosen not to be here if you had a choice to make. But the choice was made for you by Anderson not being here. And we don't know, under the circumstances, what would have caused, what would have happened. What we do know is that he's no longer here with us. And we miss him all. We miss him all. You have lost a loved one, Mama. Brothers, sisters, you have lost a loved one. And if it's one thing I can say to his children, I don't know who they are, but to his children and his wife and whoever would have known him, one thing, if I talk to you personally, you'll tell me, it hurts. Doesn't it? It hurts to know that this is what you have to do. But we can't deny our feelings. One thing I will have to say, as in the field of counseling, grieve long. Grieve long and grieve full. So when you see Mama crying, when you see someone is shedding tear, don't say, don't cry. But had you been in that position, you do not know what emotion you will be displaying. So grieve long and grieve hard and grieve full. For when you grieve, healing starts taking place. And as a counselor, I can tell you that. So, but in this field today, as a minister who is delivering this message, I say, take time. Take your time, Mama. You know how you feel. It hurts. It's never an easy job. Firstly, I want to tell you that today is a time of remembering. Nobody will forget today. Nobody that is here and who cannot be here will forget today. I have often told people that firstly, funerals are bittersweet. And you may be asking, what is sweet about funerals? It is just because they are. They are bitter because you have lost a loved one. They are sweet because you have so many memories that you can share. I am thankful God has made us with the capacity to remember. And there's a song that someone sang about memories don't leave like people do. They always stay with you. Whether they've been good or bad is something you will always have. Think of the good times. Think of the funny times. The experiences. And yes, the bad times too. And remembering, you will celebrate the life of Anderson. Today is also a time to review our own lives. Death does not tell you when it's coming. None of us knew when it would come, and none of us knows when the other person will go. But we know that it doesn't tell us when it's coming. Because the scripture tells us that someday that we too will walk through the same door that Anderson has walked through today. Thirdly, it is time to refocus our direction. When faced with death, all our plans, all our possessions, our directions suddenly doesn't seem important anymore. And if I were to ask any or every one of you what plans you had today, I'm certainly sure that you will tell me you had other things to do. But Anderson, death has brought you out of what you had to do to be here with the family and to show your face. When faced with death, all of our plans, possessions, directions suddenly doesn't seem so important. And so I ask again, what time is it for you? Is it a time of remembering, reviewing, and refocusing our lives? And I say ours because it's for me too. And we have to remember that life is unpredictable. We don't know what will happen today, far more for tomorrow, much less next week or next year. The truth is, no one can predict the future. Life is too short, here today and gone tomorrow. And definitely we have had so many funerals in this village for this few weeks here. And those who live around here will know what we're talking about. So many people have died. The truth of the matter is, all of us are just one heartbeat away from eternity. But do we ever think, or think in our minds, in our hearts, well, will it be me today, or will it be somebody else tomorrow? We don't think about life or think about death while we are living, but it's something that we ought to think about because life is unpredictable. And short to live it, not knowing your final destination. But Anderson, I know that he knew the word of God. We may count our life in years, but God said in his words, number our days. So he knew why he said to number our days. Because some of us think that we are here to turn, and I will use our local word, anchar. We all can relate to that, right? Sometimes the way we live, we think that we are here to inherit the earth. But we are here for a time, brethren. We are here for a time. Let's use that time wisely. Let us know how to live. Not where you live, you know. Because in these times, we want to know that we don't belong to Ben Loman or Marcus Street. We want to know that we live uptown, up north, and then we tell ourselves we are somebody. Things and life is not about what you consume or where you live or what you have on or what profession you are. Death is for all of us. And I said this evening, are you prepared? Anderson has gone. None of us can say where he is. We can only go by the word of God. The word of God in Matthew 7:1 also says, judge not, lest he be judged. And this is something that we all like to do sometime or another, by being judgmental. We are not here to be judgmental about anyone, because who am I to judge you? when I point at you, how many fingers are pointing back at me? So let us not be judgmental here today. We have come here today to be a comfort to those that are around us and who are here and part of the family, whether you be friend, neighbor, have come from far and wide, abroad, you are here for that purpose. So please, let us not be judgmental, because life is unpredictable. Today we are confronted with the reality of debt, and we have no choice but to think about some serious questions. What do I believe about debt? What are the important things of life? What really matters when life comes to an end? What do I believe about debt and about life after debt? What place has God placed in my life? Do I hope, or do I have a hope in the hereafter? All these are questions some one of us will be asking ourselves. But it's only you have the answer to it. And if it means that Anderson's debt have to bring you to a place where you can think about what is tomorrow. As I said before, we know tomorrow will come, but we know who holds tomorrow. But we don't know if any of us will get up in the morning. Do you think it's an alarm clock that wake you up? Because you set the clock, my friend. Do you think it's an alarm clock that you set to wake you up at 4 that woke you up? I said, it's the Lord that wake you up. He said, your time is not end. You have a time and you have something, purpose to fulfill for him. So the time that he gives you, make that time worthy. Today the scripture has come to be fulfilled that says, for God so loved the world. And you know, it is never an easy thing. And I want to say, for as I close this evening, to let you know, reflect. Reflect, think about the good times you would have had with Anderson. Think about the times that you would have had fellowship as a brother, as a mother, as a sister, as a friend, as a wife, to his children, to each one of us here today. Think about what life holds for you when we are no longer here. It's not that I'm telling you think about debt, because we all have plans. But there will come a time when I too will be in this position. It's not for him alone. It's a time for reflection. So I say to you this evening, as I close up, only you can do what you can do. Nobody else can do something that you alone know you can do. And I pray that God continue to give you the strength, because Revelation 21 and verse 4 says, he will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and death shall be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain anymore, for the former things have passed away. But as for now, we grieve. Permit yourself to feel the feelings that you are feeling. You know, and I remember preaching a message on love, and was saying that love is a feeling that you feel when you are having a feeling that you've never felt before. I just want to put it in the reverse. Chris? I just want to put it in the reverse. Death is a feeling that you are having who is alive, A feeling that you do not want to have, but yet you have it. It's a feeling that you wouldn't want to welcome anymore. It's one that you will think that, hey, I don't want to ever visit a funeral again. But do you know what? The reality of it is that it will happen. When I look at, I remember him when he would come down here. When I look at him, he say, Auntie Rosa, they call me nuts man now. I say, I am not calling you nuts man. I am calling you Anderson. And I understand today that that was the name Mama had put for him. And then it was somebody made a mistake and said, Allison. But I always called him Anderson, not knowing that was his name. You know? So I still call him Anderson. I say, I'm not calling you no nuts man. You won't remain being a nuts man. Because God has something for you to do. I say, you have started well, doing an honest day's job for honest day's pay. And we see what is happening today. As I bring you, and you know already when you look at the news, what is taking place, even in funerals. And we have a man here that all from on this side here know, and he knows only too well what takes place inside of that place. Joe is you I'm speaking of. You know, and when my son, who also works where you work, by the time the messages come on to him, and he will say, Mom, you don't need to see this. You don't need to hear this. I said, but you need to let me know. He said, because it's not a nice time, brethren, that we are living in. For somebody, he didn't just die natural death. He was shot. And it's a hard thing. It's a hard something to swallow, a hard pill to swallow. It's like drinking chandelier for those who know chandelier. And I think it's only those in my age group may know that. Chandelier is a bitter bush, but as I say, it works. It's like a medicine that they have for, that they had Buckley's, and the people would say Buckley's tastes bad, but it works. And chandelier used to work at the, in those days. But this is a hard pill to swallow. So I just want to let you know today, prepare to meet thy God. No one is too big, and no one is exempted. And sometimes we have some people who feel they are, because of the house that they're living, they are better than you are. I have news for you. Calypsonians sing this song, and you might be able, you may say, she's a preacher and she's talking to Calypsonian. Hey, I'm a Trinbegonian. I'm not one that fools myself. And the man that sing the song, he said, no matter how high you fly, you got to come back down to die. So you could walk like turkey on hot ashes. Like if your foot don't want to touch the ground, you can say that I'm dressing the best, I'm living in the biggest mansion, and you are free to say so. But I want to let you know that a day is coming when you and you alone can answer. And we can't point fingers because we all strive to do what is best for ourselves. So I'm not coming down on anybody. But what I want you to know is love one another. And if there was love, we wouldn't have Anderson here today. If there was love. It's somebody with hate in their heart. Goes to show that we all need God. And we need him desperately. And we need to let people know that there is a God. And beside him there is none else. He's the giver and he's the taker. And whatever may be your course this evening, whatever it is that you may be thinking in your mind, well, why don't this woman shut her mouth? I have the microphone this evening. It's my time. It's okay if you're thinking it. It's okay if you're thinking it. But I have the microphone, so I have your attention. I want to tell you, amongst sadness and amongst happiness, we have sadness within us, you know. So the love that you feel for him will never die. Because as I said, it's a feeling, it's an emotion that we feel. It's an emotion that will never die. The feeling that you feel, though you're having that feeling this evening, God is the only one that can fill that gap. And whatever form you may think God is for you, that's not my place to tell you what you should do or who you should pray to or whatever name you want to use, that's not my business. I am doing what is my business, you know. But let us hold the hands of our brothers and our sisters. Let us hold each other. Let us comfort one another. Because to you might just be a friend. And to somebody else, he means more. And even though friendships are even greater and more dear than some relatives, you could say amen to that because that's true. Yeah, that's a point. Because sometimes the relatives that despise you, the friends pick you up. You know, and it's a reality. So as I end this evening, I want to let you know that look up to Jesus. He's the answer for us today. And he's the only one that can take away the feelings. And the feelings will not go. Someone told me that as time passes, you forget. That's not true. Because when you get a cut or you have a surgery, the cut will heal. But you still remain with the scar. And this scar will remain. But I pray that God give you the comfort that you will need at this time. But sorrow and trouble have come as a direct result of the fall of man in the Garden of Eden. But we live in a fallen world where bad things happen to good people. It is unfortunate but true. And we will all face tomorrow, and we will all face sorrow at some time in our lives or another. The question is not whether we will have sorrow, but how we will handle sorrow. Many men do not naturally have the ability to handle sorrow, and when I say men, I mean men and women, and feel a little overwhelmed when they feel a great loss like this one today. We have a tendency to bottle up our emotions, thinking that we may be perceived as weak or effeminate if we show grief. But actually, the opposite is true. It takes great strength of character to come out from behind the facade we build around our emotions. And to be real. So I leave with you this evening. Be real. Be yourself. Whatever emotions you are feeling, you will continue to feel it for some time. Sister, you will feel it. Mother Agatha, you will feel it. Tony, Valerie, you all. All those children that are in Sunday school here, from Sunday to Sunday, the Ballah's relative, you all will feel it. Other members and villagers and friends and extended family, you will feel it. And I say, take your time and grieve. When you feel and a tear has to come, shed the tear. If somebody was to say, why are you crying? I will give you the permission to say, mind your own business. That's a good time to say, mind your own business. Not like the Calypsonians say, mind your own business and drink your water or whatever, right? But mind your business. Everything has its time and its place. But what I want to let you know, we all feel the feelings. We all feel the feelings. And you are permitted to feel the feelings. So I just want to say a short prayer before I hand over to my son, Pastor Andre. And let us bow our hearts in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you this evening, Lord, not for the debt, but Lord, we know eternal life is granted unto your Son. And I pray this evening, dear Father, for the comfort of the family, the relatives, the siblings, his wife, his children, all those of us that are in mourning somewhere or another, that you will be their comfort and their guide. And you will continue to be their guide, because this is someone who has touched the lives of so many people. And it's hard just to say goodbye. But Lord, to you, we give back your son to you this evening. And we pray, Lord, for the comfort that you will give to each and every one of us. In Jesus' name. And we all say, amen.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Let's give our pastor a round of applause. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. You know, my father had a saying, most of you all know my father. Only one life will soon be passed. Only what's done for Christ will last. That is right on that wall there. You know, all of us, we have our lives to live. We have to go to work. We have everything. But only what's done for Jesus is going to last. And today you have the opportunity to see that our brother here is lying. Do you see him carrying anything with him? His hands are empty. And we live down here for probably 70 years. And during that time, we have fallouts with our family, our mothers, our fathers, our brothers, our sisters. And we fight, you know what we fight for? A foot of land. Do you see my brother carrying anything here this morning, this afternoon? No. We fight for money, we fight for everything. And I want to encourage you all, if you all are going on that road today, stop it. Because at the end of it, you carry nothing. Nothing you carry. Only thing you carry is a good name. Stop fighting for little things. We're going to leave this earth with nothing. We came as a baby, our hands were empty. And we are leaving with our hands empty. Hallelujah. Just food for thought. Think about what I said, right? We brought nothing into this world and we carry nothing. Only thing we carry is our good name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. At this time, we're going to have a film that is the family has put together. Could we just look at it this evening? Hallelujah. Sound man? Can you just take off the back lights, please? Front lights, sorry. There's marks on it. Front right and front left. Thank you.
Help your children, and Don't let them fall by the side of the road. And teach them to love one another, that heaven might find a place in their hearts. 'Cause Jesus is love. He won't let you down. And I know
could you put on back the lights, please? Thanks. Hallelujah. At this time, we want to leave the floor open for any of the family who would like to come and say something about our brother. Hallelujah.
ALLISON BALLAH, a.k.a. Motley, a.k.a. Bling Bling. I am here this afternoon to say something on behalf of my brother. And you know, normally when you have funerals, relatives come up and talk only good things. He was a good boy, everything good, everything nice. No, my brother is not a saint. Yes, he lived his life peaceful, he enjoyed his life. Also, you know, he loved being around children and England. Anyway, you see him, he always joyful. Always joyful. He would take out money from his pocket. Yeah, we have a little competition. Only come, let me see who could sing. Let me see who could do this, who could do that. At the end of the day, yes, he lived his life, the suit. And, you know, he had women, right? He had women. But at the end of the day, we know he wasn't LGBTQRST, right? At the end of the day. And as we all know, that men don't fall, even in the Bible tells us, men don't fall was women. Right? Men don't fall was women in the Bible. So we're not holding that. We're not condemning him, because Christ didn't come to condemn, and he never condemned anyone, even the adulterers. He never condemned. When we look at, before we even think about doing that, Luke 23, 42 and 43, where he tells us, the man on the cross, I wish I was in his position, because I know I would have been, oh no, I'd have been with my Christ. Some of us, we don't even know if we would be as lucky as that man right now. Because a lot of us, we call ourselves Christians. And are we truly living as Christians? Balaam was a man, yes. Always, you know, he come to God, you know, pray, taking up train, carrying them Sunday school, whatever, dropping them. He saved a lot of people, you know. Carry a lot of people to Christ, you know. Even though, you see, he's lying down here, I feel he could get up now and take some of our little church. Seriously. That is my brother. And both of us, we always used to, he just called me Rooster, he call him Bala, he call him whatever, but we always going at each other. Always. The love that we had, it is very hard to explain. seriously. It is very hard to explain. Even though he had moved across in Tobago, living there for a few years, he used to call me, yes. Why you don't come? Spend some time. I didn't have time for that. But when I get the call that my brother got shot, death is something none of us are prepared for. But he didn't deserve to die like that. I can tell you, my brother did not deserve to die like that. Even though the guys who pulled the trigger, as we just say, gun don't kill people, people kill people. But I pray God today for the person who had done this. Forgive him. For he know not what he has done to God's child. And we have to realize this. Brothers and sisters, family in Christ, friends, today is a day that we need to live it like if it our, as if it is our last. Because we know not when our time is going to reach. Today, you could leave from here and walk outside there. Live our life with love, loving one another. Forgive one another. Know Christ. Now is the time to know Christ. This is the end time. It is the end. Whether you like it, yes or no. And you have to die. Make sure you die in Christ. You hear what it is I'm saying? Make sure you all die in Christ Jesus. My brother, yes, a loving guy, he leave. I wouldn't say he leave many to mourn, you know. Whosoever did this, leave many to mourn. Because he didn't kill himself. And that is something none of us are prepared for. None of us. And you know the thing sometimes what has happened is that when somebody die, we're supposed to rejoice. But they like it, yes or no, because you know why? That person is no longer in the world to face any troubles. No longer in the world to go through any troubles. The Bible tells us it is best to be in the house of mourning than to be in the house of feasting. Why? Because you will sober up and understand that you could be next at any moment. And Bala is giving you that self-realization right now. Think, you could have been that person there. But it's my brother. And as we all know, at the end of the day, God is in control. God is in control. So my thing is, even though, yes, you know, we'll say, let us rejoice and he won't be there. And sometimes, even though, when a child is born, we like to have christening and all this thing. When that is the time, all you should be crying. Because all you don't know what a child is going to face today or tomorrow. All you realize what is before us right now in the world today, the LGBTQRST, and they're bringing it on the little children. All you really realizing what it is going on in the world today. Pray for all your children. Pray for our children. Bring them up in the way so that they would not depart. He would be a happy man to know that today. Very much happy man. So this is my words today to my brother. May God take his soul and rest in peace. And may we still have the joy within our heart. Still have that joy within our heart to love one another, keep the love, and let your light shine so bright so that men can see thy good works and glorify him which is in Christ Jesus.
A pleasant evening to each and everyone. No, I see you hugging balls. I am here. We go back far. We go back real far. Valerie, my sympathy. You know, they usually say, blessed are they that mourn, that they shall be comforted. This is what I come to do this evening. So, Joe, I'm not taking long. You'll get it soon. I want to comfort you and let you understand it's only the body that is here and the spirit still lives on. Because you're going to continue to see that spirit somewhere along the line. I might say, hey, you know, I get a dream. You know, Allison, they call me. You know this, you know that. Because the spirit of God works that way. Right? There is a writer that say, shall we ever all meet again? Shall we ever all meet again on that great judgment morning, and a book shall be open and your name shall be called? That is when you're going to meet again. We all will meet one another again, but not in body, but in spirit. But as we see this body lie down, it is an understanding for everybody here. Are we ready? Are we prepared that when we die, we go to the Lord? Because if your name shall be called, how sad it going to be when you take your departure and turn away from heaven for not serving God. So this body is showing you something that we could start, as the minister say, we could start to change. We could start to change because something, it happened. We cannot do anything now, but we need to prepare ourselves for this time. And to prepare ourselves is to serve God. I am very short. I will stop right there. Show a hand over to you one time.
Well, I'll be very brief. I was going to be brief, but I'll be very brief now. Because half of my time gone. That joke I'm making. What I want to say? Well, I'm Joe. Everybody know me as Joe. Well, Joseph Nelson. Allison. Anderson, Grumpy, Motley. See, people remember all the names. Because I know this guy from since he came to Belloman. I remember back in the early 80s when I was working at the grocery. And he was at the tire shop. That one of the earlier jobs. I can't remember if he had any job before that. He said, Joe, I will own a tire shop in the future. And I laughing, nah, that can happen. But I have grown to see and live to see that he has outlived just owning a tire shop. He owned stores in Tobago. And when he left Trinidad, as they say, 17 years ago, and he went to Tobago, nah, you're playing mad. Tobagonians love themselves. You are going to make. He made it. So, and I think I'll be brief. Ali boy, what I going to say? You did it your way, which was important. But what is significant that I would like everybody to take from today? What this guy had achieved in 57 years, some of us will take at least 3 lifetimes to achieve. So before I get more emotional, on behalf of my mother, who would have liked to be here, who is presently in America, Mommy, I know you're watching. I would like to say my deepest condolences, because the Nelson family and the Bala family have always been extremely close, extremely close. And to all the other members, because back in the days, it hardly anybody living between the Trace and all the road. It ever set a new member, no way, you know, so I was glad at this moment to meet up some of the new ones. But in general, big man, you did it your way. And I urge your family members and other people to take one page from your book as to how to balance life, manage life, and go through life and be successful to some degree.
A pleasant good evening, everyone. Everybody here, am I properly right?
Hallelujah.
I just come up here to give my memories. I just come up here to give my memories of my father. I see my name down as stepchild, small thing. I'm a father. If it is he was here today and he was introducing me to any one of you, he would have said, this is my big son, and that's what he is to me. Moms, thanks for making him, and thanks for sharing him. Because the amount of memories that I have with him, it will never fail. He teaches me how to be a man. And I'm feeling real bad that I've seen him here lying in a box now, but I just had to get up and say thanks to him for making me into the person that I am today. I want to say my fond memories of him is where I and my siblings were with him, getting up on a Sunday, having to go to church, no matter if you're sick or not, church was it. When it is your home in the evening, as soon as he returned from work, he will call you, come, time to serve God. We have to pray as a family before we go to bed. And I remember giving some trouble at time. My mother tried to catch me to beat me for the trouble that I give. I ain't going to say it was the trouble. But when my stepfather, my father actually, come home, he had something he used to say. Ronnie, Ryan, Rihanna, and Anne-Marie, come here. And from the time I hear that, you know licks coming. But the licks was worth it because it made me into the person that I am today. And I remember him doing some stuff when he was working in Trinrico. When he now started to sell nuts, everybody knew him as the nuts man. I knew him as the man who used to put 4 children in a box that used to sell nuts and ride from Belloman to Reform to go home in the evening. And I remember some of the things that he used to be telling me. That in my life, as a man, you had to do certain things to be where you want to be. You can't give up. Your work ethics must be whatever it has happened the day before, tomorrow you had to go again. And now I see him here, and it hurts me so bad that I don't know why it has happened, but God have a reason for everything. And all I want to say to all is, he body lying on here, but his soul bawling out for joy because he's not here in this physical body anymore. Where he is, we may not know, but he will meet us again someday. All the tears that we share now, it might be tears of sadness, it might be tears of joy, but at the end of it all, the man, I could call him by name now, because before when it is he was alive, I never used to say Allison Balah. I used to always say daddy, because the last time I say Allison, I get lash. But Allison Balah was a perfect father to me. I don't know how he was to everybody else. And I don't want to know how he was to everybody else. To me, I want my memories to be the only memories that I have of him. I thank him for everything that he do for me and the siblings. And to everybody else, holy faith. Thank you.
Yeah, good afternoon. Chris Balah, good afternoon to the friends and the guests and the relatives. This is my uncle here. I don't think I can say much again, like I'm not good at words, right? You know what I mean? But I just want to say thanks to everyone for coming out and supporting the family. You know? We are tears, but we are a strong family. I hope this little incident will make you stronger.
You know, we that long hair. None of we have long hair. None of we have long hair. Right? And who want to come and say anything again? Anybody?
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Good afternoon, everyone. I just want to say I know Bala 30-odd years. Bala, since I come into the family, I know I was loved. There is no question about it. My memories of Bala is what he did for me and my children. I remember when me and he first met. I had four little children with no father. And he was there. He built us our first home. It wasn't a big house, it wasn't perfect. It was a home. And in that home, he used to turn that step went from downstairs to the side, to the back. Every time Bala would renovate the whole entire house. Until one day I tell him, I say, thank God it's not a concrete house we have, because what will you do? How will you change it around? My fond memories of Bala is working in Chaguanas, hustling. We used to sell on the streets in Chaguanas together. We used to sell Port of Spain by KFC selling honey roasted nuts. And you know, it had a time when there was no books for my children to go to school. Sorry for the nervousness. There was no books for us to go to school. And Bala had nothing to sell. We had nothing selling at those days. He went to cement factory and buy paper, brown paper in the rolls, the big brown rolls. And he carried every one of my children and myself to Chaguanas. And we sell brown paper. When I tell him, I say, Bala, I said, his father had him in court for maintenance, he never paid. I said, boy, how are we making it send him to school? He said, don't worry now, something will happen now, God will provide. And we went to Chaguanas and sell, and he sell paper to buy books for my children. I didn't have none for him at the time. We wasn't even married at the time. And he was there. And you know, those are the memories that will stick with me. And as Ronnie said, we were living a stone throw from the church. And Bala will get us up early in the morning, jump in that vehicle. He had a vehicle. It wasn't a perfect vehicle, but he will jump in that vehicle. And we could walk, and he will drive. And sometimes when we go, coming back, the van will shut down. And I'll say, boy, we could walk this. He is a guy that always loved children. He always loved children. When his sibling came to live with me, we had a good time. We had rough times, we had good times. Unfortunately, our time had expired. And he moved on. And I'm not angry for that. Because I have my time. I had the time with him that I wanted. We share good memories. People may not understand what it is about. Sometimes you cry, but not because you're sad or you're sorry. Memories play with you. And Allison was always a good person to me. Me and he got baptized together because we were going to get married and we had to be baptized first. And we got baptized. So I know. I don't know who know and who ain't know. I know. The man that he was and is in heaven waiting. And I hope and I know that I'm trying my best to make it. He already gone. There is nothing we could do for him anymore. But we could do for ourselves to have a hope that one day we too could be where he is. Because he made it. He made it. Before we were born, God knew every mistake we're going to make. He knows every flaw and he allows it. We are not to judge, as the first person said. We may know the things that we see him do, but we don't know the heart. God don't care about the person. It's a relationship he come for. And I pray that we get that relationship with God so that we can have a hope of seeing him one day to come. Praise the Lord.
Hello, anybody else would like to come and share?
Yeah, I'd use them. Well, never really was always around my father, but three times I was around my father. I could tell you he was a good man. Never did no wrong. Just here, smoke and drink. Never did no crime. Always on the hustle. Always try to provide for your family. Any means. Any means. I see him in the good moments and the bad times. And might never be half the man he is, but hopefully one day.
Good afternoon. I'm Therese. My daddy was perfect to me. My daddy was the best. My daddy gave me everything I asked for. My daddy was the best. My daddy, I thank God. For my daddy. I thank God that I had my daddy. I used to live Trinidad, and every time I come off the boat, my daddy used to take the phone, the same phone he buy for me, and switch it off. And he said, I ain't not time for phone. It's time to spend with your daddy. I thank God for my daddy. He's the best daddy ever.
Good afternoon, everyone. Well, I know many of you don't know me, but I bring son-in-law, right? This is my wife here. I just want to share a fond memory, because initially when I first came to Tobago was to meet him, right? And I remember being introduced to him, and I was expecting the typical reaction from my father that, hey, with the intentions from my daughter and all of this. And I wasn't greeted with that. You know, he was very accepting of me. And so that he gave me a little driving test. There was a vehicle parked by the guest house. And you had to have some skill to move this vehicle, eh? Otherwise, you're sure bongs. And you know, like he gave me this little driving test to see if I could drive. And from there, it always had a vehicle waiting for me in Tobago. That is one thing. I saw a vehicle waiting for me in Tobago, a place to stay. I never pay accommodation in Tobago. Thanks to Lana too. Chrissy, you know, you always accommodate me too. All right, so I don't know if I share a little light moment about my meeting him. And everybody would have something to say, whether it's good or bad, but I only know about my interaction with him. And I don't have anything negative to say about the man. You understand? And I say, as far as our father-in-law goes, I never had any other father-in-law, but as far as our father-in-law goes, I believe I had the best. All right? For the way the man treated me over the years, and his acceptance of me, and somewhat, maybe his tolerance of me at times. All right? So, to the family, let's hold strong. All right?
Anybody else this evening? We don't want to rub you off. Hello.
Good day, everyone. I met Bala 18 years ago when I just came to Tobago. I was cashing in the drugstore just opposite the port, and he came in to cash some stuff, and he found out I was too serious cashing. So for a whole week, he came just to get me to smile. We became friends after that. And then I introduced him to my sister, who is the mother of his last two children. Thank you, Bala, for giving me those two beautiful children. And his other children, Crystalline. Crystalline worked under me in Subway. I trained her. They are like Cherise, Crystalline, Ricardo, Kyle. I know Kyle, a baby in hand. They are not my step-niece and nephew. They are my nieces and nephew. I remember his son couldn't get him to stop drinking and bottle. I said, I will do it. I get him to stop drinking and bottle and give him a cup with straw. And from ever since, we have always been good friends. We fall out. As they say, Bala was not as perfect. He was very ignorant anyway. We fell out, good time, and we fall out so bad that I didn't even, I had to stop talking to him because he didn't want to admit he was wrong. But we stayed good friends. And even though he did not marry my sister, he was my brother-in-law, best friend. He was a best friend to me because he helped me a lot. He helped me with my business, my food business. He passed on one of his business to me. And from ever since, all my children, Uncle Bala, they can't stomach to come because they want to remember him the way how he was. You understand? I don't know his entire family. I know his mother, two of his sisters. But you see his children, trust me, as long as I'm alive, they wouldn't want for anything. Christine, Cherise, Kyle, you know, he's my son, not just my nephew. Ricardo, I love you all. And you see how they rob my little niece and nephew. Yesterday she turned 6. This is last year she got to see her father. But he lives on. He lives on. That's all I have to say.
Hallelujah. Anybody else this evening? Hallelujah.
My father was a good man. Every day he was hustling, providing food for us.
Hallelujah. We know it's a tough time for all of you here. Anybody else would like to say something before we close up? Hallelujah. Now is the opportune time. Thank you, Jesus. If not, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We just want to close up the service this evening. And you can come and view the body. And let's all close our eyes and bow our head this evening. Thank you, Jesus. Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you this evening for we know that you are King of Kings and you are Lord of Lords, God. We lift up your holy name. I pray that you will touch the family that is here, the Bala family, the extended family, the grandchildren, the great-grandchildren, our mother, Lord Jesus, our brothers and sisters, God. I pray that you'll comfort their hearts. Lord God, even the day, Lord Jesus, when you cried, in the scripture says, Lord God, we wept, Lord. I pray, Father God, that you will comfort all of our hearts, all of their hearts this evening in the name of Jesus. I pray that you will touch them, oh God, help them, Lord God, to recognize that one day they will soon see their uncle and their father and their brother. Lord, I just give it a praise, I give it honor. I pray that you will touch your people that are here this evening in the name of Jesus. And even as we are about to leave this place, you're going to touch us. Give us traveling mercies, O Lord, for we ask all this in Jesus' name. I pray with thanksgiving. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. So if you would like to view the body, please come and you can view the body and then you can go outside. We will be going up to the Bellarmine Cemetery to lay his body to rest. Hallelujah. So God bless you. Thank you for being a good audience. God bless you and have a wonderful evening. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
children and don't let them fall by the side of the road. Heaven might find a place in their hearts, 'cause Jesus is love. He won't let you down, and I know children, and don't let them fall
other side of the road. And teach them to love one another, that heaven might find a place in their hearts. 'Cause Jesus is love. He won't let you down. And I know we've got to walk on, walk on through temptation, 'cause His love and His wisdom will be our helping hand. I know the truth and His word will be our salvation. Lift up our hearts to be thankful and glad that Jesus is love. He won't let you down. And don't let them fall by the side of the road. And teach them to love one another, that heaven might find a place in their hearts. 'Cause Jesus is love. He won't let you down. And I know we've got to walk on, walk on through temptation, 'cause His love and His wisdom will be our helping hand. I know the truth and His word will be our salvation. Lift up our hearts to be thankful and glad that Jesus is love. He won't let you down. And don't let them fall
side of the road.